Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at one of the new features in DaVinci Resolve 18, and that is the Surface Tracker. What is the Surface Tracker? It's a cool tracker that will allow you to track logos and stuff like that into fabrics, t-shirts, faces, whatever. We are going to test that out in this video and see what the Surface Tracker can do inside of DaVinci Resolve. Oh, and by the way, if you want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's get right to this tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's get right to the tutorial. So let's just jump into the Color tab, because we can actually do this effect inside of the Color tab. So I'll go up to my effects, and I'm just going to write, yes, you are, and here we have the Surface Tracker. I'm going to add this directly in here. So that's where we have it here. And I'm also going to take this photo right here, and that is going to be a mat, which are the stuff that's going to be tracked on. So I'm just going to show that. Shut down the media pool. Alrighty, so here we have our clip here of this guy walking, and I want to take this YouTube Shorts logo and I want to have it on his shirt. So this is pretty straightforward. So on the tab Bounce, we're going to draw in a shape where we want our logo to be. So this square right here should do just fine. And if we go into mesh, we can actually see all the lines and everything here. This is what is going to be tracked. And it's straightforward. So we'll go to the tracking, and I'm just going to push this icon right here, which is going to track forward and back. So here we go. And now DaVinci Resolve will do its thing, and it's doing a pretty fast job in the color page. It's very special to have a thing like this in the color page. Is more compositing than color grading, but of course nice that they put this in, I guess. You could also do this effect, of course, in Fusion, and I'll jump to that in a bit and show you how that would work. It's pretty similar and pretty straightforward as well. So now it's just doing some analyzing of the texture, which is kind of cool. So there we have it. And now we just need to connect our mat. And we do this by taking this green output, and we're going to put this into the green input in the Surface Tracker. So here we have the logo. We're going to go to Resolve. And now we have our logo. Of course, there's some things we need to change. So first off, I'm going to go to Overlay Placements, and I'm going to push go to Reference. So I'll jump to the frame where I originally did the mask. And here I can either use a canvas or sliders. In this case, I think I would use canvas. I'm just going to make this fit here like that. So now the logo is actually tracked on, so we can push play and it's there. But of course, this is not blending very well, so to do a better job at that, we could go to the compositing mode here, and I'm going to change this into multiply. And there we have it, pretty fast and pretty easy to add in a logo. So we can just go to the edit page, and here we can have a look at our thing. And a thing that's pretty cool is that it's actually moving around with the shirt, so it looks like it's on the shirt. I think this is super duper cool. So let's go to the next clip here. Same clip, but this time we're just going to go into Fusion. So like all the time we're doing something in Fusion, we have a media in here and a media out. Nothing strange there. I'm just going to push Shift Spacebar. And of course, I'm just going to type in Sir, and it's right here. And I'm just going to add the Surface Tracker into this thing. And the Surface Tracker needs to be in between the media in and the media out. Well, nothing special there as well. We'll go up to Bounce. And yet again, I'm just going to draw in a square like so. And I'm going into the mesh again, and we could, of course, give this more points, but it's not really necessary for a thing like this. So I'll go into the track, and I'm just going to push forward and backward. And now DaVinci, yet again, will do its thing. And I think it's doing the exact same thing as in the color page, or it is actually doing the exact same thing. The only difference is, of course, now you can see all of the keyframes that's being pushed into this composite. And it takes a little while, but it's pretty darn fast, in my opinion. So we have 300 frames to run through, and it's doing a pretty decent and pretty okay fast job in that, I think. Also, it doesn't really matter if you do this in the color or in the Fusion page. It's pretty straightforward in both tabs. However, it's kind of new that you can do it inside of Fusion. I think that was added in beta 4, I do believe. So it's super cool that now you can choose where you want to do an effect like this. And it's, again, pretty similar. It doesn't matter where you do it. It is doing the same thing, more or less. So here we have the thing. It's just going to think for a second, because it, of course, doesn't look very tracked now. But if we go to push space now, you'll see it's tracked just fine. So we'll go to the result. And this time, again, we're going to take the YouTube logo. I'm just going to shut down my media pool, and I'm just going to connect that to the surface tracker. There we have it. And again, with the surface tracker selected, I'm simply going to go to overlay placement, go to reference. And again, this time I'm going to use the canvas yet again. And I can just zoom in here and make this look like I wanted. Something like that. And of course, again, I'll need to composite the white away. So I'm just going to go into composite, and I'm going to go multiply. And then, of course, we could change the opacity if we wanted to, you know, be a little less visible. But I kind of like it like this. So here we go. Done in Fusion. Same thing. It looks very, very good. And it's a very, very nice effect. Thank you for adding this into DaVinci Resolve Blackmagic. Well, anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.